This is the story of a Lombax named Ratchet and his robot friend Clank and the muscular, irresistibly handsome hero who helped them save the galaxy.
Ratchet and Clank have been saving the universe from evil ever since their introduction nearly 20 years ago on the PlayStation 2. Now, poised to jump into their next adventure, and with it, the next generation of consoles, it's a great time to brush up on their planet-hopping adventures before Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart hits the PS5. The PlayStation duo's journey spans 16 games so far, but we're focusing only on the mainline titles made by Insomniac Games. Many of the spin-offs and mobile games don't have as much bearing in the overall story, so whether you're new to the series and can't tell your buzzblades from your pixelizer, or a veteran looking for a quick recap, here's the story of Ratchet and Clank so far.
Oh boy.
Just remember what I taught you.
What did you teach me?
Interesting.
Yay!
You're quite handy with your wrench.
The original Ratchet and Clank introduced, well, Ratchet and Clank, each living on separate planets. Ratchet, a young Lombax mechanic who called planet Velden home, spent his days working on a homemade spaceship while Clank resided in a robot manufacturing plant on the planet Quarto. One day, Clank overheard a pre-recorded message revealing Chairman Alonzo Drek, overseer of the Blarg race and owner of Drek Industries, planned to build a device to harvest and destroy entire planets while aiming to build a new planet of his own. Terrified of the prospect, Clank quickly escaped Quarto but was shot down, crash landing on Velden where he had a chance encounter with Ratchet. After some initial disagreements, the two teamed up to help one another, with Clank crucially offering the missing component to power up Ratchet's spaceship. After some interplanetary travel, the two meet the enthusiastic Captain Quark, one of the galaxy's most popular superheroes and an all-around great guy. Or so we thought. Quark sabotaged the two after training Ratchet to become a hero by leaving them to die at the hands of a snagglebeast, after which he revealed he worked for Drek as the spokesperson for his new planet and was tasked with taking the duo down. Eventually, they engaged in an epic space battle against Quark where he was ultimately dispatched. But not permanently. Ratchet and Clank aren't that cold-blooded. Ratchet and Clank turn their attention to taking down Drek and his planet-destroying device, aptly named the Deplanetizer, on Velden. The heroes defeated Drek in battle, sending him hurtling through space toward his newly constructed planet, which is blown up, Drek included, by the villain's own superweapon. With the galaxies finally at peace, Ratchet and Clank become besties and returned home together.
I thought it was time to get you a new run.
Before we continue on, it's worth mentioning that the 2016 Ratchet & Clank reboot is largely a reimagining of the original PS2 story, with some notable changes that interfere with some of the later games taken as canon. So it's sort of a reboot, but also kinda not? The biggest changes included the introduction of Dr. Nefarious, a villain that wouldn't be seen until the third game. Quark also didn't work directly for Drek, at least not originally. Instead, he led the Galactic Rangers and was tasked with recruiting a new hero. He ultimately became jealous of Ratchet's growing popularity and joined Drek to stop Ratchet from outshining him. In the end, Quark regretted his decision and helped the two stop Dr. Nefarious, somewhat redeeming himself. However, Quark was thrown in jail for betraying the Rangers, which is actually used as a framing device for the whole game. Anyway, it's not that important and serves more as a what-if entry for the franchise.
Welcome!
What the...
I'm Abercrombie Fizzwidget, founder of the Megacorp Company in the Bogon Galaxy.
Getting back to it, Ratchet and Clank are recruited by Abercrombie Fizzwidget, the CEO of Megacorp, a year after saving the galaxy to help recover a top-secret stolen experiment. Clank reluctantly stayed behind while Ratchet flew to Aranos to investigate. While the thief narrowly escaped with the experiment, Ratchet continued following leads until he received a message stating Clank had been kidnapped. After switching courses and saving Clank from the thief's hands, the two pursued the thief across the galaxy, eventually landing on Siberius. Ratchet finally finds a stolen experiment and ultimately discovers that the thief is actually an ex-Megacorp employee named Angela Cross, a female Lombax like Ratchet. Rivet, you're not the only one. She revealed the stolen experiment as an upcoming product called the Protopet, a seemingly harmless fuzzy blue creature that can mutate and reproduce rapidly. It's actually extremely dangerous. Ratchet, Clank, and Angela try to stop Fizzwidget from mass producing the small killer creatures, but are shocked to find that he's actually Captain Quark. What a twist! Quark pretended to be the Megacorp CEO while throwing the real Fizzwidget in a broom closet so he could release the destructive protopets only to single-handedly destroy them using a special device, thus becoming a hero in the eyes of the people once more. While trying to demonstrate the device, he accidentally mutated a protopet and was quickly devoured. But again, don't worry, he was fine because Ratchet disposed of the massive protopet, saving Quark's life, and the group put an end to the remaining protopets via a radio signal sent across the galaxy.
But do you lose as gracefully as you win?
I would not know, Maximilian. I never lose.
Sometime later, Ratchet and Clank saw a news report that Velden was under attack by an army of Tyranoids led by the mysterious and aptly named Dr. Nefarious. After teaming up with the Galactic Rangers to push back the initial forces, the duo must find Captain Quark once again, as he's the only one who's ever defeated Nefarious. They find Quark on Florana, moonlighting as the Florana tree beast, apparently losing his memory and his sanity after their previous encounter. Following Quark's rescue, Ratchet and Clank restored his lost memories and learned Nefarious has constructed a new super weapon called the Bio Liberator, a device that could turn any living creature into a robot. The trio track Nefarious to a star cruiser called the Leviathan, where they found themselves trapped. Nefarious set the Leviathan to self-destruct, and while Ratchet and Clank escaped, Quark seemingly perished in the blast. Seriously, this guy has no luck. Shortly after successfully destroying the Bio-Obliterator, the duo found there was an even bigger and badder Bio-Obliterator being finalized at Nefarious' base on Mylon. Ratchet and Clank battled and seemingly defeated Nefarious there until he activated a new super weapon and turned himself into a giant armored robot. Just before he could crush Ratchet and Clank, Captain Quark returned, revealing that he had faked his death, and together they all destroyed the new Bio-Obliterator. With his defeat apparent, Nefarious teleported to an asteroid deep in space, and our heroes enjoyed a moment of peace.
I see you're taking good care of my old ship.
Well, she needs a lot of tuning up, but I've kept her running.
The peace didn't last long, however, as Ratchet and Clank and many other heroes were captured and taken to a hostile and lawless part of the galaxy known as the Shadow Sector. Here, Ratchet met Gleeman Vox, a multimedia mogul and creator of the Dread Zone, a televised blood sport that pits heroes against one another, often against their will. Forced to wear a deadlock collar and participate in the gladiatorial battles for fear of his life, Ratchet battled his way through the tournaments, quickly growing in popularity, while Clank tried to fight his way to disable the collar and secure an escape for them both. After Ratchet defeated the champion Ace Hardlight, Vox offered to make him the Dread Zone's newest superstar, showering him with money and fame. Ratchet declined, and as punishment, Vox sent him to the Ghost Station, a nearly impossible arena that would surely be his demise. Ratchet narrowly escaped and returned to the Dread Zone, where he reunited with Clank, who found a way to deactivate the containment field around the station, allowing them to escape along with the other trapped heroes. However, Ratchet discovered that Vox rigged the entire station to explode and was forced to fight him. Just before his defeat, Vox hit the self-destruct switch because, of course, forcing Ratchet, Clank, and the others to flee. As expected, the duo escaped by the skin of their teeth, while Vox and the Dread Zone station exploded in the distance. For once, there wasn't a near or fake death experience for Captain Quark.
Ratchet? Clank? I've got a bit of a situation here at the Planetary Defense Center.
Nothing I can't handle, mind you, just a few thousand
heavily armed robotic commandos, but I figured, hey, if you were in the neighborhood, maybe...
After the futuristic bustling city of Metropolis was attacked by an alien race of Droffids, Ratchet and Clank meet their new foe, a villain named Emperor Percival Tachyon. He was the last surviving member of a race known as the Cragmites, who were otherwise wiped out by Lombaxes during the Great War, which took place long before the series started. Tachyon was hunting down Ratchet, believing him to be the last living Lombax, as he sought to bring his race back to its former glory using ancient Lombax technology. After boarding his warship, the duo were placed into hypersleep, and Clank was visited by the Zoni, a mysterious race of beings that allowed him to see into the future. They explained to Clank that he was built for a very special purpose, unknown to him at this point. Ratchet and Clank head to a remote space station where they meet an ally named Talwin Apogee and eventually learn of an ancient Lombax device called the Dimensionator. This helmet allowed the wearer to open portals to another dimension and was previously used during the Great War to dispatch the Cragmites. After seeking out and acquiring the Dimensionator, and then reacquiring it after it was stolen by Captain Slag, the leader of the space pirates, Captain Quark, that's right, he's back, took the device to the Cragmites' home planet Repor, where he planned to destroy it. Unfortunately, he, along with the Dimensionator, was captured by Emperor Tachyon. Way to go, Quark. Ratchet and Clank battle Tachyon, damaging the Dimensionator in the process and sending Tachyon into a black hole. Just as everyone celebrates their victory, the Zoni show up and kidnap Clank, taking him into an unknown dimension.
Once upon a time, there was a fearless young Lombax who gained fame and fortune by ridding the galaxy of Emperor Percival Tachyon and Captain Romulus Slag.
With Clank in the hands of the Zoni, Ratchet and Talwin learned of a space pirate named Captain Darkwater who may know how to contact the mysterious beings. Unfortunately, he's super dead, but he did leave behind a device called the Obsidian Eye, which could communicate with the Zoni. After retrieving an item to power the device, Ratchet found out Clank had been exposed to Zoni energy, damaging him and causing him to lose his memories. Thankfully, the Zoni had a great doctor who could help patch Clank up. Dr. Nefarious. With Clank's location revealed, Ratchet set off to rescue his friend from the Zoni and the evil Dr. Nefarious.
Have I ever told you about my son? Remarkable boy. Quite smart.
A crack in time opens up with Clank still in the hands of the Zoni and the mad scientist Dr. Nefarious. He's been imprisoned inside a Zoni construct called the Great Clock for over a year, with Nefarious trying to gain access to his brain. Unsuccessful, Dr. Nefarious unleashed a device called the Hypersonic Brainwave Scrambler, disrupting the Zoni and the Great Clock with its sonic waves and allowing Clank to escape. Shortly afterwards, Clank learned of Orvis, a highly intelligent Zoni who revealed himself to be his father and true creator. However, he's been missing for 2 years after meeting with Dr. Nefarious. He also learned that the Great Clock is an extremely powerful device capable of altering time. Meanwhile, Ratchet and Quark are en route to save Clank, but crash land on Quantos. They were attacked by one of Nefarious' assassins, who mistook Ratchet for another Lombax named Alistair Azimuth. Ratchet escaped and actually met up with Azimuth, as he was one of the few remaining Lombax and a friend to Ratchet's father. He told Ratchet about the Great Clock and devised a plan to help him get his parents back, as well as the entire Lombax race. The two were finally able to communicate with Clank through another obsidian eye, at which point he asked the two Lomboxes to travel back in time through a portal and save his father from Nefarious. While they were largely unsuccessful, Ratchet does finally save Clank, who warns him of the danger of using the power of the clock incorrectly. Ratchet abandoned his plans of saving his family so as not to risk anything that could alter the universe, and Azimuth left disappointed. The two infiltrate Dr. Nefarious' base along with Quark, where they learn of Nefarious's nefarious plan. We are so sorry. To use the Great Clock's power to create a reality where supervillains always succeeded against the heroes as a way to undo his previous defeat. But of course, that doesn't happen, as Ratchet and Clank defeat Nefarious once more. Clank chose to honor his father's wish and stay with the clock, and Azimuth is still intent on using its powers to bring back the Lomboxes. After refusing again, Azimuth killed Ratchet. This just got really dark. But Clank turns back time using the clock's power to save his life. Now slightly back in time, Azimuth reached the clock's control center and began rewriting time. Ratchet and Azimuth battled it out as the clock began to shatter around them, and Ratchet reasoned with Azimuth. Realizing the mistake he made, Azimuth sacrificed himself to stop the clock, saving it and the universe in the process. Afterwards, Ratchet helped the Zoni repair the clock, and Clank reconsidered staying behind after hearing a final message from Orvis. But he chose to continue adventuring with Ratchet instead. Aw, friendship.
Deactivating cryosleep on prisoner 9971. Prague. Vendra. Please stand by.
As Into the Nexus opened, Ratchet and Clank were flying the dangerous criminal Vendra Prague to a prison ship so she could carry out her life sentence. However, the crew was attacked by her twin brother Neftin Prague, who freed Vendra. Narrowly escaping death after the ship's explosion, Ratchet and Clank informed Talwin of the situation and set off for Yarrick in hopes of recapturing the twins. But they found Yarrick has been abandoned and is now haunted by ghosts. They also met Pollux, a scientist who previously worked for Dr. Nefarious and was kidnapped by the twins for his research on the Netherverse, an alternate dimension inhabited by others like Neftin and Vendra. After Pollux outfitted Clank with a Riftcracker, he and Ratchet were able to cross over into the Netherverse. There they came across Mr. I, the leader of the Nethers, who sought to destroy the two. Thankfully, Captain Quark showed up to save the heroes once again, as Mr. I began mounting a full-scale invasion while betraying Vendra and banishing her to the Netherverse. With little hope left, Ratchet and Clank meet up with Neftin, who devised a plan to save his sister and defeat Mr. I. In exchange, Ratchet made the twin promise to turn himself and his sister in once she was returned. Ratchet then stole the Dimensionator from the Intergalactic Museum of History and returned it to Neftin, just as Mr. I attacked the city. While Ratchet took care of Mr. I, Clank used the Dimensionator to locate Vendra and bring her back to their reality safely. Once the twins were reunited, they pushed Mr. I and his army back and sealed them away in the Netherverse once and for all. After saving the galaxy once again, Ratchet returned to his now girlfriend Talwin, while Clank secretly took the Dimensionator. Of course, we know that the Dimensionator plays a big role in Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart, the next chapter in the duo's journey. We'll find out what rifts and dimensions they're taken to, and what Rivet's role is in all of this when Rift Apart hits PS5 on June 11th. But until then, check out Rift Apart's performance review as well as some information on Rivet, the new Lombox who will be joining the heroes this June. And for everything else across the multiverse, you're already in the right place with IGN.